4. Stevie
Wonder.
Very good, good. What possessed you to do this song?
It was a lot more difficult with the
riffs?
Yes. To be honest, I put a lot more in there than I feel as it was actually in the music.
So you improvised a little bit? I think so too. Kind of added your own twist sometimes, and I'm sweating right now. I'm not on camera, am I?
No.
Good. You know what I'm directing, and we're at Cameron. Tell people where we're at. Where are we? What store?
Melody Mart.
What's that? What town? Homewood, Illinois. What's the date?
I think it's the 18th. Okay.
Of what?
April.
April 18th, 2016. 2016. And a Cameron, what's your last name? Dave Cameron?
Cameron Dunlap.
Come on, spell it. D.
D-U-N-L-A-P.
All right. And what are you, 18, 19, 20? 13. What?
13.
How old are you?
13.
13.
Yes.
So you're in senior in high school?
No, eighth grade.
Eighth grade. Eighth grade. Awesome. All right. Who showed you this song? Give out your secrets. Who showed you this song?
No.
Was it me?
No.
Oh, it was not me. And I'm your bass teacher. Sad. Another teacher?
No.
Music. Did you read it? The only thing left is a magic wand. What someone did it. So how'd you figure it out?
Played it by ear.
Played it by ear. So you would listen to the original song like
yes,
this,
yes.
That little, and just how you just slow it down or just.
I pause it a while.
Pause it.
Get the parts down.
Awesome. That's how you play. This is pop music from the 70s, and I think if you can't. This is how you play pop music and blues and rock and roll, is by ear. If you can't feel it and play it by ear, you really can't play rock and roll. You can't read rock and roll. No. No, not at all. So this is definitely one of the hardest pop songs probably in the history of popular music from like 1954. It
perhaps.
Is. It is.
Perhaps.
It is.
Perhaps.
That long riff, the classic riff right there.
Perhaps.
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 Perhaps the hardest.
I mean, I know it's a hard one.
Oh, it's up there. It's on a 10 out of 10. Sir Duke. But anyways, that was awesome. But no one showed you that. So that's the... Would you recommend to bass players coming up and coming, would you recommend try to do this... Play by ear, or would you try to? What would you recommend how to get to your level?
Well, to be honest, I don't really think that it matters. I mean, you could probably read off the music, but learning a new song would be a lot harder.
Off of.
So it's a nice skill to have.
It'd be a lot harder if you had to read it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly. Good call. So, what it is? Just keep working on your ear, right, Cameron? Tablature. You've heard of tablature, right?
With
the one, you know, color by numbers.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that? Does that help you at all?
No.
Do you ever look at it?
No. Nope.
Because what'd you see? Nothing that would add up or.
I can see where it helps people, but then what's the point of the music?
Right. Then what's the point of reading music, right?
Then you won't actually learn to read the music.
Right. Exactly. That's great. That's it. Game over right there. Just learn how to read music instead of tablature. Right. All right. We're here at, like I said, Melody Mart.
Yes, Melody Mart.
I'm John Falstrom. Cameron's, well, coach, maybe. I don't know. I didn't teach him nothing from this. Just kind of like hang out. Cameron, who's filming your video?
My mom, Mike.
Say hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
All right, Cameron, that was great. That was awesome. That's why I had you film this to show what can be done with your ear and the power of practice and the power of playing by ear. Total feel, total excellence. Cameron, I know we've done a few other ones, but how about if we both say goodbye in this one, everyone, okay? You ready? All right, see you, everyone.
Bye.
Bye-bye.